Smith Sheets, Senior International Business Major from Fort Mill, South Carolina. Welcome to the inaugural edition of Inside Wofford College. First, we have the remarkable learning experiments conducted by Dr. John Pilley, a Wofford Professor Emeritus of Psychology with his dog, Chaser. Pilley's former student and current Wofford Psychology Professor, Alliston Reed, is helping to document data on Chaser's achievements in order to present Pilley's findings to research journals. Here's what they had to tell us about their work.
In 2004, there was an article, a German dog by the name of Rico, who had earned over 200 words. So, decided, let's see what the boundary might be.
And what have you found out?
Well, we found out that the boundary, we don't yet know. We do know that Chaser has been able to learn the names of over 1,000 objects. We think we're just on the frontier. Border collies, with this domestication and herding sheep, it's necessary that the border collie keep the eye on the sheep, but be attentive to the master. So over the centuries, dogs that weren't attentive to the language dropped out of the gene pool. And so that's why most of us believe that they have this special ability for language exceeding even that of apes.
Wait a minute, there. Come by, stay out. There. Wait a minute. There. Good girl. Drop, Chase, drop. Drop. Crawl, girl. Good girl. Stand. Get back, Chase. Back. There. Step. Stay. Step. Step, Chase, step. Step, stay. Okay, one, two, three. Good girl.
This article is about border collies in National Geographic. And they're asking questions that are very similar to the questions that he has been asking about the degree to which animals such as border collies might share some of the same sort of verbal abilities or language acquisition abilities that humans have.
It takes 16 large Tupperware tubs to house all of Chaser's toys. Here we find Chaser peering out over this mass of toys, over 1,000. We ask ourselves, does she really know the names of all these toys? The answer is always yes. Each month, when we test her memory for the unique name of each and every toy, she correctly remembers the name of 95% of all the toys. In order to document Chaser's learning of 1,000 words, we sought the help of the Wofford Psychology Club. We asked 10 students to randomly select 50 toys for Chaser to retrieve upon verbal command. In order to inhibit Chaser's finding of the toys on the basis of physical cues rather than words, the toys were placed to my left and behind my forward vision.
Good girl. It's on your tongue. Find sunflower. Find sunflower. There's sunflower. Shake. Yeah, shake. Shake. Turn around. Yeah. Shake. Okay, good sunflower. Good girl. Find it. Find cactus. There's cactus. Put it tub. Watch cactus. Watch cactus. You ready? Stand. Get the cactus. You were a little slow. The cactus is tough. Good girl. I'm worm. There's worm. Squeeze worm. Squeeze it. I can't hear it. Squeeze. Okay, we'll put it in the London Bridge. Find London Bridge. There's London Bridge. That's good. Find it. Poppy. Find Poppy. We'll find Poppy. You want to do something else, don't you, huh? Well, let's do a few more. Find Poppy. Get Poppy. Find Bamboozle. Find Bamboozle. There's Bamboozle. Get tough. Bozo. Find Bozo. There's Bozo. Find Bozo in town. Find Sweet Potato. Sweet Potato. Enter.
Find Big Rope. Find Big Rope. Find Big Rope. Find Big Rope. Good girl. Put Big Rope in tough. Find Professor. Find Professor. Find Professor. Good girl. Find Poison Frog. Find Poison Frog. Good girl. Find Spook. Find Spook. Good girl. Dapper Duck. Dapper Duck. Good girl. Chase. Find Chicken. Find Chicken. Good girl. Find Goose. Find Goose. Yeah, squeeze Goose. Squeeze Goose. Shake it. Yeah, squeeze, shake it. Shake it. Okay, good girl.
Our findings showed that of the 50 toys randomly selected from 1,000, Chaser successfully retrieved on the basis of first alone 46 of the 50 toys.
Bozo.
Bozo.
Find Bozo.
The key thing is to try to teach the dog two concepts. One is knowledge that objects have names, but then the dog needs to learn some cue as to how we connect the words with the object, so that the dog has to know what particular object the words refer to. And our procedure was just very simple. We simply held an object before, holding it in our hand, saying, this is rabbit. I'm going to hide rabbit. I want you to find rabbit. So then we hit the rabbit. And then while she's looking for the rabbit, we're using associations of the name and the object. Chaser, find rabbit. Find rabbit. And my theory is that while she was searching for the rabbit, somehow or another that word, the name, stayed in her memory. I don't know this for sure, but I'm pretty sure. So that within a span of a few minutes, the name of the object and the actual object itself was being paired. And this is good old classical conditioning. And somewhere along the way, the hypothesis is that somewhere along the way, after those many objects that she was learning, there was this inference, objects have names. And when I say this is, then that's the cue that helps her to identify the name with the object. We're replicating some research that was done over in Germany. We are carrying it a little further though, I think, in that we're pushing the boundaries. The boundaries, not 200 words or 300 words. We don't think it's even the boundaries of 1,000 words. But we are pushing the boundary to a degree and showing that she can learn not only the name of objects, but she can also learn words that are common nouns, which represent categories.
Well, we appreciate you coming.